Good morning, students.
Good morning, ma'am.
How are you?
We are fine, ma'am.
But ma'am, I have a query. You know what happened when today our maid came for work? She was crying very badly. You know what happened? She gave birth to a girl child and her in-laws are blaming her for this. And you know what? They told her to leave their house.
Really? But ma'am, what is her mistake? How she is only responsible for that?
Good question, Prashant. You are absolutely right. Female is not only responsible for the birth of a child. Determination of gender of the child is a biological phenomena.
Ma'am, please explain in detail.
Okay. You know about chromosomes? They are the units of heredity. They contain genes which are responsible for body characteristics and determination of sex of an individual. Let us study about different types of chromosomes in humans. There are total 23 pairs of chromosomes in human body, out of which 22 pairs are called autosomes and the remaining one as sex chromosome.
Ma'am, is there any difference between sex chromosomes and autosomes?
Autosomes determine the body characteristics of an individual, whereas sex chromosome determine whether a person would be male or female. To understand this, let us have a look at the computer screen. Males have one X and one Y chromosome, whereas females have two X chromosome. Now, what happens during reproduction? After meiosis, males produce two types of gametes. Half of the gametes contain X chromosome, whereas the other half gametes contain Y chromosome. Whereas female produce only one type of gametes, which always contain X chromosome. Now, what happens after fertilization? Now, there can be various possibilities of combination of chromosome during fertilization. To understand this, let us have a closer look. If a sperm containing X chromosome fertilizes the egg which always contains X chromosome, then a female child is born. Now, students, can you tell me what will happen if a sperm containing Y chromosome fertilizes the egg cell containing X chromosome?
Male child will be born.
Absolutely right. Now, you have seen that sex of the unborn child is determined by the type of the sperm that fertilizes the egg. So, we can also say that male parent or father is responsible for the sex of the unborn child.
Ma'am, does this rule apply to all organisms?
No. There are some other methods of sex determination also in some other organisms about which you will study in higher classes. But interestingly, in some organisms like turtle and crocodiles, the temperature of the surroundings in which the fertilized egg is kept determines the gender of the organism. But remember, in humans, this is the only method which determines the sex of the unborn child which we have discussed today. Now, I hope that you have got answers of all your questions.
Yes, ma'am.
So, can you briefly summarize what you have learned today?
Today, we learned that there are two types of chromosomes in human body, autosomes and sex chromosomes. There are two types of sex chromosomes, X and Y in males, whereas only X chromosomes in females.
During reproduction, if a sperm containing Y chromosome fertilizes the egg, then sex of the baby is male. Whereas the sperm containing X chromosome fertilizes the egg, then the sex of the baby is female.
Very good, students. I am very happy that you have understood the concept well. With this, we end today's session.
Thank you, ma'am.